Philippine media personality Ramon Tulfo arrested on cyber libel charges. An arrest warrant for Tulfo was issued Wednesday by a Manila court, but details of the complaint remain unavailable. The Manila police said a certain attorney, Leon Cruz, who represented the unnamed complainant, sought the help of the police for Tulfo's arrest. According to Tulfo, the charges stem from his failure to attend court proceedings. His lawyer says they will file an urgent motion to lift the arrest warrant against the media man. Tulfo is detained at the Manila Police District Headquarters.
I just missed one or two hearings. Because I was in China as a special envoy. Hindi naman ako, I didn't mean to disrespect the court, pero hindi ko na, nakaligtaan ko lang. Kasalanan ko, nakaligtaan ko lang yun. Kasi wala naman akong balak na hindi, this job-related itong mga kasong ito.
Court of Appeals Justice Maria Filomena Singh is the newest member of the Philippine Supreme Court. This was confirmed by Executive Secretary Salvador Medialdea. Singh takes over the post vacated by retired Senior Associate Justice Estela Pelas Bernabe. Singh is the sister of health spokesperson Undersecretary Maria Rosario Vergere. She was among the CA justices who dissented in the January 2018 ruling of the CA ordering the release of ex-Palawan Governor Joel Reyes. He was suspected of killing broadcaster environmentalist Jerry Ortega in 2011.
President Rodrigo Duterte expresses his gratitude to Filipinos who stayed loyal to him during his presidency. Duterte is preparing to step down from office on June 30. He spoke in Pasay City Wednesday during a convention of retail giant Pure Gold. Speaking at the event, Duterte also stressed the importance of small and medium-sized enterprises to the Philippine economy.
I am on my tail end sa presidency ko. Pero yung tumulong sa akin, nagsuporta all these years, at yung umintindi ng mga hangarin ko sa ating bayan, I would like to express my gratitude sa inyo. This administration has always recognized small and medium-sized enterprises as one of the backbones of our economy. With the countless jobs that SMEs produce for the country's growing labor force, the aid in our aim to utilize our people's talent and in our fight to reduce hunger and poverty.
Chinese President Xi Jinping holds a phone conversation Wednesday with leading Philippine presidential vet Bongbong Marcos. China's ambassador to the Philippines says President Xi once again congratulated Marcos on his electoral victory. The Chinese leader supposedly described Marcos as a builder, supporter, and promoter of the friendship between China and the Philippines. The two also talked about bilateral ties and regional development.
The incoming Philippine President's choice for Migrant Workers Department Chief admits her battle with cancer may affect her decision on whether to accept the post. Migrant Workers' Rights Advocate Susan Ople was diagnosed with stage 2 breast cancer in 2020. Ople had to undergo chemotherapy and PET scans.
That will be a lifelong concern. To be honest about it, whether I accept the job or I don't accept the job, sa akin kasi panata ko na yung to serve our OFWs in whatever capacity. Mm-hmm. So definitely it's a factor.
Ople says she wants to consult migrant worker groups and other stakeholders before making her decision. She reveals the offer to head the newly created Migrant Workers Department was made during a meeting with Marcos last Friday at his Makati City residence. Meanwhile, Philippine poll watchdog PPCRV says election returns encoded by its volunteers still show a high match rate with the May 9th vote tally of the Election Commission. The Parish Pastoral Council for Responsible Voting reports a 98.88% match rate after encoding over 60,000 poll returns. It says 327 returns still have to be revalidated. Nearly 80,000 election returns out of the total 107,000 are now with the PPCRV. Of that number, 55,000 are from Luzon, 16,000 are from the Visayas, while 7,000 are from Mindanao. Poll returns from overseas voters have yet to arrive.